Adesso siamo a bordo di un altro dei Class 40 in gara, si chiama HBF Reforest Action, ma soprattutto siamo a casa sua, a casa di Quito de Pavan. Lui è un grande, un grandissimo della vela oceanica. Pensate, 3 Van de Globe, un numero incalcolabile di traversate oceaniche. Lui stesso prima diceva che non sa calcolarle. Thank you for having us on board your boat, Quito. It's your third time at Palermo Monte
yes,
Carlo.
Yes, we love this race. Yes,
why?
Because the race is perfect between Sicilia, Sardinia, Corsica, and Monaco. So just perfect.
It's a line in the Mediterranean.
Yes, yes. For us, we are Mediterranean. We are on the west of Mediterranean, in Port Camargue, and it's a real pleasure to come here in Sicilia.
And class 40, class 40 is a class growing in Italy.
Yes.
And we have actually 4 class 40 in this Palermo Monte Carlo. And you told it before in the press conference that you are working with Pietro Luciani and others to increase this participation.
It's a class incredible. There is 170 boats built in 15 years. So it's a lot. There is a lot of new boats. And in Mediterranean, there is perhaps 10 boats in Italy, perhaps 5 or 6 boats in French. But next year there is a Route du Rhum, and a lot of skippers want to do the Route du Rhum. And this class, the kind of boat, permit to lot of skippers to do with not a big budget.
Tell us something about this boat. Who is the designer? How old is the boat? I saw that you changed something on the boat.
Yes, this boat is a TIS-40 designed by Guillaume Verdier. Guillaume Verdier, you know, it's a designer of a team New Zealand. He works in New Zealand, and he works a lot with this kind of boat in Imoca, but also in Class 40. And we changed a lot of things this year on the boat. We changed the bow.
Yes,
of the boat,
we cut a piece of the boat.
We cut 3 meters of the boat, so it's a great
job. Why? Is Guillaume that decided this? Or
yes, not? yes, of course, we call Guillaume, he's a good friend of me, and we call Guillaume during the winter, and I'll tell him what we are doing. We have two options. Built a new boat, but it's very expensive, of course, or change this one. So it's a good boat, and we have some problem with reaching. There is a lot of new boats
with
big bow.
Yeah,
A SCO. And they go very very quick. Sometimes not always, but sometimes.
It's a move to make this boat and more close to the SCO.
Yeah, and we do some works medium between a new boat and the old one.
Before it's
changed a lot of things of the boat. It's not the same boat.
Before to go inside and to have a visit with you, I give you the microphone and you visit for the people at home your boat. Last question is, what is the difference between the oceanic sailing and the sail in the Mediterranean?
There is some similitude in each part of the world. It's the same thing. And we have a chiller like this. We have some ropes, we have sails, it's simple, it's the same. But in Mediterranean, there is a lot of mountains, and it changed a lot of things. During the summer, there is not a lot of wind, but when there is some wind in the west basin, generally the wind don't cross the mountain. And in the east of Sardinia, there is no wind. Just that.
That's the challenge.
Yes, it's a challenge. We have to learn patience.
You have 2 on board.
Yes, only 2. We prepare the Transat Jacques Vabre. You know, it's a great race in France, starting from Le Havre in Normandy, and this year the finish is in Martinique. Usually it's Brazil, Brazil or Colombia, and this year with the COVID, the organizers changed.
please, please.
Yes, the organizer changed the plan and we go to France, but in West Indies, French West Indies. Indies.
Fantastic place. Little question that I have for you is, in Italy we complain often because we don't have a big culture of offshore and ocean sailing. Yeah. You are French and French is the referral point in the world. What Italy and Italian sailors can do to grow up in this way?
So I think the difficulty to convince sponsors. It's the same in media, in France. Yeah. There is France, yeah, there is Brittany and south of France. Huh? Okay. South of France, exactly the same problem with Italy. It's the same problem. I think we are very far from the start of the race. There is Vendée Globe, Route du Rhum in Saint-Malo, Transat Jacques Vabre in Le Havre, in the north of France. We are very far from this this start.
So it's a problem. It's a matter of finance.
So it's a real difficulty to find a sponsor, but we arrived to.
Well, yes, for sure. Okay.
Okay, welcome on board of HBF River Section. It's a class 40. Not very big boat, it's a 40 feet boat. In front we have it's the place for sails, but generally the sails are back, but just for the moment is just here. We have bag with all the items here. Hop, like this, we change everything when we have to tack. Here, kitchen. Just one thing, very important, is that. Very simple, huh? Here, only one bed. When we sleep, it's like this. And on the back there is two little bed, but we put everything on this place. It's only thing. The engine is here, and all is outside. Yeah. Here we have a very good place to see everything, to with a look with the instrument, here with the winch, and it's very, very habitable.